but he shared his father's love of sports and possessed the self-confidence of the natural athlete. He realized early in childhood that he was better at physical activities than most other kids. At Morgan Park Academy, his prep school in Chicago, he played football, baseball, basketball, and was a member of the swim team. But it was basketball at which he excelled. In his senior year, he averaged 30 points a game and was named one of the top 20 high school players in Chicago. With college scouts sitting in the stands, he scored 53 points one night, buoying his dreams of being recruited by major universities. Those dreams did not pan out, but Duke University and Davidson College, both prestigious institutions, both in North Carolina, expressed interest in him. And in the spring of his senior year, his mother went with him to visit those campuses and talk to coaches. His grades kept both schools from offering encouragement. Since he was in the area, Tom wanted to stop at Wake Forest College in Winston-Salem, where Horace Bones McKinney had built a winning basketball program with an assistant named Billy Packer. Wake Forest had a new coach and a losing season in 1966, but Tom showed his newspaper clippings to Packer and came away feeling good about the possibilities. Wake Forest might find a spot for him, Packer told him, but he would have to play his way into a scholarship. First, he must prove himself on the freshman team. Tom enrolled as a pre-med student. Encouraged by his mother, he had long talked of becoming a doctor. Although his grades were not so good in his first year, he ensured his scholarship by averaging 6 points a game on the freshman team. And in 1967, the year Wake Forest became a university and got yet another new basketball coach, he became a substitute guard on the varsity team. To his disappointment, he never would rise above substitute, averaging less than a point a game for his college career.